Shop Talk Episode 5 is sponsored by Jared Robertson of Sacred Boxing, where they're making the hardest sport easy. They help novice athletes mimic the thoughts and movements of a professional boxer. Locate them on Instagram at LoyalToMyCraftApparel, Bodywork at Work, or www.sacredboxing. Also, the Marion House, your premier event venue located in the heart of Manning. You can contact the Marion House to host your celebrations and parties. The number is 803-410-0728. The address is 1079 Capitol Way, Manning, South Carolina, 29102. Their email is themarionhouse@gmail.com. You can also visit their website at themarionhousevenue.com. Higher Learning Tutoring Center. Not looking for perfection, just determination. Providing homework assistance, tutoring service, and workshops to the youth in Manning and surrounding areas. You can contact them at 803-433-4821 or 803-460-7815 or email at thetutoringcenter29102@gmail.com. And also the address is 534 West Boyce Street, Manning, South Carolina, 29102. And Train So Hard University, but it's just not a movement, it's a lifestyle. You can contact the owners, myself, and my brother, Terrence Miller, on Facebook at Excalibur Miller, on Instagram at _TheMillerExperience, or at ProdigalSon36 on Instagram. Shop Talk Episode 5 is dedicated to my brother, Brian Legacy Sleeper Bowman. Rest in peace, my friend. We love and miss you. Welcome to the Mill Experience, Episode 5, where we have four special guest guys. Mr. Tyshaun Conyers, a.k.a. Ty Obama, Ms. Kyndra Johnson, Ms. Karen Sanders, a.k.a. Lady K, and my boy Elijah Bradford. Y'all say hello.
Hello.
Hi.
All right, this show is about just our perspective. We speak from the heart, we speak our minds, we're very intelligent with it. Y'all ain't got to like it, but please respect it. All right, my special guest today, can y'all please introduce yourselves and tell y'all who you are and what you do and what you got going on? Starting with Tyshaun.
My name is Tyshaun Conyers. I'm a native of Manning, South Carolina, residing in Augusta, Georgia. I'm self-employed, started a few businesses over the last year and a half, so that's my lifestyle right now. I'm a dad, husband, all that good stuff.
Awesome. Ms. Johnson?
I'm Kyndra Johnson. I am the district social worker of Clarendon School District 2. I'm the foster care liaison, and I'm also the truancy officer, and just glad to be here.
I'm Karen, Lady K. Hilton Sanders, and my official job title, I'm working for McLeod Health Fitness Clarendon. I am the assistant manager there. I'm a mother of four, grandmother of soon to be five. I enjoy being out in the school, supporting the children on and off the courts, off the academically and athletically. You'll find me some of everywhere where there's something going on positive. Mm-hmm. I love to sing. I'm an author of a children's book. We'll just carry on to the next guest. I have a lot of jobs.
I want to, before you get started, she went the wrong shirt today. She tripped.
I'm Elijah Bradford from ElijahBradford.com. I'm a singer, songwriter, musician, author. Music is my life. I eat, sleep, breathe music. That's what I do. So anything dealing with music, that's me.
Alright guys, well how we normally start off the show is what I like to call self-check. Basically we're from our mental health, checking our mental health from 1 to 10 to see where it's at. All right, so I'm gonna start off with you, Tyshaun. Give me your mental health level from 1 to 10.
About 8, a solid 8.
And why is that?
Just life in general. Mm-hmm. You know, we'll get into discussion of part of what's bothering me now later on, but for right now, just life overall.
Gotcha. Yeah. What about you, Gabe?
Now, On the 10 side, that means I'm all stressed out.
No, one means stressed out, 10 means everything's peaches and cream. Yeah. One means stressed out, 10 means everything's peaches and cream, bro.
Well, I'm a 10. Yeah, everything's 10. Going great.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. How about you, Q?
Honestly, I'm kind of somewhere in the middle. I'll say a 6.
Okay.
And I mean, it's crazy. It seems as though I would be at a much better place, and in many ways I am. Spiritually, I am. Family-wise, in regards to my nuclear family, I am. My career, I am. But family challenges has me somewhat down at the lower end of the spectrum, because it's just drama, I guess. Biggie Small said it, more money, more problems, you know what I mean? Just, you know, I didn't ask for the blessing, you know, it fell in my lap. And I'm gonna be a steward of it, because that's what God has designed for me. So, I mean, it is what it is. But just pray for me.
What about you, T?
No, I'm normally a 10, but I'm going 5. Y'all feel like we're easily manipulated by the media, and we ain't got no hope.
Next.
I'll elaborate later.
I will.
I would say I'm a 8, only because I'm always looping. I'm a thinker, so I'm always looping, trying to figure out how to break through that next level, that next ceiling. So I would say a solid 8.
Lady King?
Some days I'm a 20. And some days I'm a 5, depends on if I'm tuning into the news or hearing what's going on in my local community. If something's rough going on and I feel like I want to solve the problem, I feel like I'm like a 4 or 5. But most days I'm 10 to 20, dealing with my grandbabies and my children, my husband, and my water class at work. They keep me going and it keeps me kind of well balanced. And on the sideline with sports, then I'm about 100.
I'm about a 7 or 8. I just got on vacation and already thinking about work on Monday and trying to prepare for the next school year. So that's where my mind is a little bit right now.
Well, normally I'm at 8, 5, whatever, but today I'll say 3. And the reason for that, shout out you gave being a 10, I need to get there. But reason for that, I don't know if you know this guy. T, I know you know him. Terrence, I know you know him. Lady K, Kyndra, Brian Bowman. Yeah. He was supposed to be here today. Oh. So I'm going to dedicate the show to him. So today I'm at a 3 on that. It's disturbing to me some of the things. I'm not going to go in depth. It's disturbing some of the things that I see on social media in reference to his passing. With people, when they find out the individual who did it, then the size change. Oh, you got a family too. You know, both sides of the family lost someone. That's bullshit. There's only one person that lost, and that's Brian Pant's family. His mother, his 2 daughters, and his brother, his little brother. When you sit here and break this situation down, this man lost his life because someone couldn't get in the club. In Pattsville, South Carolina, everybody knew everybody.
Yeah, man, that's crazy.
When you sit there and break that down. But yet, Black Lives Matter, right? But you wonder why everybody say all lives matter.
Right.
This is why. Because we don't give a damn about each other. Not everybody, but just some. This is why they say all lives matter. Because we don't give a about each other. So that's why I'm at a 3 today. You want to elaborate on that?
I think we kind of need to focus on the actual catalyst of what happened. Mm. You know who set it off. Mm. And how disturbing it is that it's that person's mother. Now, that person is supposed to protect you, or at least keep you out of harm, mm-hmm. or trouble, throughout your whole life. But it's terrifying that your mama would get that kicked off. Mm-hmm. Most likely this person's gonna get off too.
Mm-hmm. And I agree. Wow. T, you wanna say anything on that?
I mean, that caused my 8. It did. Can't save the world, but here in my local community, it's not really where I grew up at, honestly. As far as the crime, and so often, so repetitive. He had a vision. I mean, I commended that young man, saluted him, like he said earlier. his daughters, his brother. I won't speak too much on that situation. I just think it's goofy. I talked to two of his friends, Pat and China, asked them how they felt when they first heard what overall since all this happened, you know, how do you feel? It's just senseless. His cousin, Roxanne, I talked to her. She stated she's confused still. She's won justice. That's all we can ask for, justice for Sleep. Rest in peace, brother. We love you.
We love you, Sleep. Dedicated to you, man. You're supposed to sit here with us today, brother.
Can I add something to that?
Good.
I'm also noticing I don't see nowhere near the same vitriol for the person, people that committed a person that committed this crime. Especially in comparison to whenever a cop take the life of a person you don't even know. But you'll see so much anger to the point of getting frustrated and even going on Facebook because you can't even have a logical debate with these people about, okay, let's play devil's advocate when we think of this. Put yourself in that position. Would you have done the same thing? Was this cop protecting himself? So there's always questions that go along with that. This is black and white. No gray area.
Yeah.
But you don't see nowhere near the same amount of disgust or anger when it comes to this. Give that person, those people, that same energy.
Yeah, I don't care.
If you really want to say that person's, a black person's life is important, then hold them accountable just like you don't do that white man or that white cop. Because you don't do that, nobody gonna take it serious.
That's what I was saying. That's why they say all lives matter. Because with us, dude, just because they know the individual that did it, nah, it's cool. You know what I'm saying? We don't give a damn about each other, man. Not everybody. Not everybody. I'm not saying not everybody, but just some of us. And it's just crazy to me, man. That was in my heart. I was in the 8, but today it just hit me. He was supposed to be here with us, so I'm at a 3 now.
Man,
this man is brilliant at what he does. I don't know if y'all seen some of his work. The man was homeless in L.A. for a while. You know what I'm saying? Because he was doing films and everything. That's how he was making money, doing films. He was homeless in L.A. till he got himself together. Then he was able to move back to Manning. Then got a job in Atlanta. He come back here for the weekend. Not for the weekend, for the summer. He's going to train with me and my brother. And, you know, start doing some videos with us. And then, boom, this happened. This man was just here for the summer, living his life. Hanging out with mama.
Wow.
You know? So like I said, man, you break it down, it's senseless. Man lost his life. Again, in Pattsville, South Carolina, where everybody knew everybody. Because they couldn't get in the club. When you put it that way, that's stupid, senseless. Let's move on.
May I say one last thing?
Go ahead, bro.
Before we cut off. That's why, and I wasn't gonna say anything, to be quite honest, but it's just in my heart right
now.
That's why it's so important, honestly, to have a relationship with Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
You know, because the only way that we can overcome all this hate, this anger, this pain, this frustration that we express to ourselves and to others is by love of Christ. You know, so it behooves all of us to take this seriously because we never know when our last day.
Exactly. Yeah.
You know, we think we're gonna live. We have plans for 100 years, but you never know when it's your last day. So Christ is the answer.
All right, we're gonna start off this first topic.